Hello friends, today we are going to discuss one important topic in accountancy subject, that is what bills of exchange. So we are going to discuss today and one important topic, that is bills of exchange. Let us come to know what do you mean by a bill. So bill is nothing but it is a negotiable instrument and which can be easily transferred by one party to another party. Bills of exchange or bill is a negotiable instrument which can be transferred by one party to another party easily. Why generally this bill is generated? Let us come to know today. No doubt so many transactions will take place in business on the basis of credit. So whenever credit transaction takes place in between two persons, there will be debtor-creditor relationship will be established. Say example, if you sell the goods and receive the money and there is no any further relation continued between you and also the other person. But if goods are sold on credit basis and there will be a relationship established between both of you, like a debtor and creditor relationship. As and when goods are sold on credit basis, and obviously the other person will become a debtor in your books. Say example, you sold goods to X on credit basis 10,000. Entry will be X account debtor to sales. X is a debtor in your books. Say example, you are given a credit period of 1 month or 2 months. And obviously at the end of the first month or second month, once the expiry particular term given you is expired, you will get back your money. Say example, you are given 1 month time or 2 months time. After 1 month or two months, if you approach the party, say if the party denies to pay the money and you cannot approach the court because there is no any kind of in writing, so commitment is not there between both of you. So as and when goods are sold by you on credit basis, so whenever the other party became debtor in your books, so better you can have a bill in writing. If it is in writing, the bill you are having in writing, then obviously if the party denies to pay the money after 1 month or 2 months on the due date, definitely you can approach the court and to get back your money. You can sue against him in the court because it is in writing. Rather than oral, writing is always better. So that's why these kind of bills of exchange is very quite familiar and they regularly take place in regular business units, like a bills of exchange or a promissory note in the way of promissory note. But of course writing entries related to both will be same. But very importantly, in the bills of exchange you may find three parties. And the three parties, who are the three parties? Drawer, drawee, payee. The person who draws the bill is known as a drawer. The person who will draw the bill, always who can sell the goods, and the person who has to receive the money, that person has to draw a bill. The person who has to pay the money, that person will accept the bill. The person who draws the bill is always called drawer. The person who will accept the bill is called drawee. And on the due date, who will collect the money, he is called payee. And you may have the doubt, obviously, the person who draws the bill and he will collect the money. But you can't say every time the money will be collected by the only drawer. Of course, drawer may collect the money on the due date, but only under one situation, but not under every situation. Because already I dealt that bill of exchange is a negotiable instrument. So it can be easily endorsed by one party to the another party. So every time drawer may not become payee. So at the end of the period, who will collect the money, he is called payee. So how many parties are in the bills of exchange? Drawer, drawee, payee. Drawer means who draws the bill. Drawee means who accepts the bill. Payee means who collects the money on the due date. But of course, drawer can become payee, but not under every situation. So three parties involved in the bills of exchange. Generally, in case of promissory note, you may find only two parties. They are maker and payee. And who will make the promissory note? Who will prepare the promissory note? He is called always maker. The person who will get the money on the due date, he is called payee. Only two parties, maker and payee. Another very important difference between a bill and promissory note is, bill is always drawn, the person who has to receive the money. A promissory note is always written by the person who has to pay. Basic difference between both of these two. And I would like to repeat once again, a bill is always drawn by the person who has to receive the money on the due date. The person who has to pay, he will accept. But in promissory note, it is not like that. Who has to pay the money and he will make the promissory note. And it is very clear in either bill or promissory note, acceptance required in case of bill. Because the person who has to receive the money, he will write. On the other hand, the person who has to pay the money, he will accept. If he is not going to accept, and definitely that won't become a bill and it is simply a draft. As and when the drawee accepts that bill, and it will be called like a bill. But in case of promissory note, the acceptance is not required. Why? Because the person who has to pay the money, he himself preparing the promissory note. So when I am saying to pay the money on the particular date, then what is the necessity to accept that particular one? So in case of bill, acceptance required. In case of promissory note, acceptance not required. In case of bills of exchange, there are three parties, drawer, drawee, payee. In case of promissory note, only two parties, maker and payee. In case of bills of exchange, the person who has to receive the money, he will write. The person who has to pay, he will accept that. But in case of promissory note, who has to pay the money, he makes the promissory note. So it does not require any kind of acceptance. But of course, as far as entry is concerned, accounting entry is concerned, so whether it is a bill or a promissory note, you will write the same kind of entries. Okay. And today I'm going to discuss in detail all types of entries related to bills of exchange. And already I said that a bill is a negotiable instrument which can be easily endorsed to any other party. Say example, and I have drawn a bill on you. That bill is endorsed by me, sir, to somebody. And the due date, that concerned party who is having the bill, he approached you to collect the money. But you can't deny to pay that money, because who is the holder of the bill? To that person you have to pay the amount. Need not to myself, I have to come to you. Anyone may come to you and who will present the bill and to whom you have to pay. So bill is a easily transferable instrument, negotiable instrument. Now today we can discuss how bills of exchange, entire topic, and of course by this class you can handle any kind of sum related to bills of exchange. So bill, already I said that how many parties are there? Three parties are there. Drawer, who draws the bill, he is always like a creditor. Second one is a drawee. He will accept the bill. He is always like a debtor. Payee, who will collect the money on the due date. Sometimes you may find drawer may become payee, but not under every situation, because it is a negotiable instrument. I can deal the bill once a bill is drawn by me and the bill is accepted by the drawee. I can handle that bill with me in four different ways. I can handle that bill. First one, I can retain the bill with me. That bill is retained with me, means till the due date I can keep the bill with me. On the due date I can approach the drawee to collect the money, and of course on the due date he may pay and he may not pay, that is a different matter. But in bills of exchange we can call that if the on the due date the bill is paid by him, it is called honored. If bill is not paid by him, it is called dishonored. Obviously when bill retained with me, this is what I can say, bill retained with himself, bill retained with him till the due date, and he approached himself to collect the money and he may deny or he may pay. If he can pay on the due date, and it is called honored. If it is not paid by him, it is called dishonored. Second one is, and when bill is discounted into bank. What do you mean by discounted into bank? Say example, a bill drawn for rupees 1 lakh rupees. My name is A. I have drawn a bill. I am the drawer. I have drawn a bill on B. B is a drawee. I have drawn a bill for amount of rupees 1 lakh and the bill 3 months period duration bill, 1 lakh bill. Say example, the bill is drawn on a particular day. Just after 4 or 5 days, I need urgently that 1 lakh rupees. So can I collect from drawee? Not possible, because the due date has to come. Particularly, very importantly here, say example, January 1st a bill drawn. That is a 3 months bill. Particularly, I can say if January 1st, 3 months being added, January 1st, February 1st, March 1st, April 1st. April 1st is the due date. If I, every bill can have 3 grace days. If I add 3 grace days, April 4th will be the maturity date. If you add the term, only term, that is a due date. If you add 3 grace days also, that is a maturity date. Payment should be done on maturity date. And of course, this particular date is a public holiday, the payment should be done the preceding day. If the, that is a unforeseen holiday, the payment should be done in the succeeding day. Otherwise, the amount should be paid on this particular maturity date after adding 3 grace days to the due date. In fact, I can get the money from the drawee who is B only on April 4th, because that is the maturity date. Say example, on January 5th itself, I need the money. Just by 3-4 days, I need the money. I cannot approach the B and I cannot collect that money. But of course, I need. So even though I am having bill with me and I need the money, I am unable to fulfill my commitment. But of course, there is no problem. You can sell your bill to the bank. You can discount that bill into the bank. Of course, bank people will discount certain charges, and remaining amount is given to you. You can happily, comfortably, you can use the amount. But of course, on the due date, the bank will approach the drawee to collect the money, because it is a negotiable instrument. Who will present and to the concerned person you have to pay. And of course, B can may honor and B may dishonor. If having enough money, and he may honor, and otherwise he may not honor the bill. That is discounting the bill into bank before the due date. Generally, before the due date, we, if you need the money, you may sell it to bank. That is called discounting the bill into the banker. Come to the third one. Endorsement of a bill. What do you mean by endorsement of a bill? Say example, I received a bill from B, but I am due to C 1 lakh rupees. C is repeatedly asking me, please give me 1 lakh rupees. Then I said that simply I cannot give right now, but of course I received a bill from me, B, that I am having that bill with me, I can endorse that bill to you. So please take that bill and collect the money on the due date directly from the B, and then he may accept. So I can endorse my bill, bill is receivable, and to the C. That is called endorsement of a bill. Obviously, in case of endorsement of a bill, who will approach the B to collect the money? C will approach. But of course, the person who will endorse the bill is known endorser. To whom the bill is endorsed is known as endorsee. The process is known as endorsement. Endorser, endorsee, endorsement. So that endorsee will approach the drawee to collect the money on the due date. And of course, again, he can say either honor or dishonor. Last one is the bill sent for collection to bank. Bill sent for collection to bank. What do you mean by bill sent for collection to bank? No doubt banks are rendering so many services today, so that I may send the bill to the bank to collect on behalf of me. So bank will collect on behalf of me that particular amount. And for that, bank may charge to certain amount like a bank charges. That is a different matter. But I can send the bill to bank for collection. So in that case also, bank will approach the drawee B to collect the money. He may say honor her, he may say dishonor also. so that whatever the bill I receive for the sale of goods, I have drawn a bill and acceptance received, need not to sale of goods, and otherwise some amount is due from the other party. For that amount, I might write the bill and the other party may accept it. So the bill, whatever I received with a particular term, I can handle that bill in four different ways. First case, I can retain the bill with me till the due date. Second one, I can discount the bill into the bank. Third, I can endorse the bill to my creditor, my NDRC. And fourth one is, I can send the bill to bank for collection. In all the four different cases, B draw on the due date, he may say either honor or dishonor. Now we are going to discuss how to write the entries in four situations. How to write the entries under four situations when it is honored. How to write the entries for dishonor in the four situations. And so many other different entries also. So let us come to know all the different entries involved here under four different situations. Okay, we can discuss right now all of them. Say example, I am giving a transaction here, and let us see how to write in the books of two different parties. Here I am explaining transaction in the books of drawer, in the books of drawer, in the books of drawee, in the books of drawee. Need not to say every time drawer, drawee. I would like to name him like a X, and I would like to name him Y. In the given case, drawer is called X, drawee is called Y. Now let us see how to write the entries under the different situations. For example, sale of goods to Y, or X sold goods to Y. When X sold goods to Y, let us say rupees 10,000. When X sold goods to Y, 10,000, how X is going to write the entry? Y account data to sales account. We know very well. 10,000. When goods sold to Y, entry will be Y account data to sales. Let us think from Y point of view. How Y is going to write? He purchased goods from X. He will write the entry purchases account data to X account. Purchases account data to X account. 10,000. See that because of this kind of sale and purchase transaction, and the other party became debtor in our books, and of course, and X became creditor in the books of Y. Debtor creditor relationship established. As and when the other party became a debtor, say example, I have drawn a bill for 3 months period, and that is also accepted by Y and given back to me. So a bill drawn and acceptance received for 3 months from Y. A bill drawn by X for 10,000 rupees because the other party became a debtor, and the Y accepted that bill and given back to X. How X is going to write? Say example, if you receive a cash from Y, cash to Y, check received from Y, bank to Y, now bill received, bill to Y. But of course I can say this is a bill receivable to us. So I would like to write the entry bill receivable account at R to Y account, 10,000 rupees. I am receiving the bill from Y, bill receivable to Y. How the Y is going to write? If he is going to pay the X cash, X to cash. Paid by check, X to bank. Now, but right now given a bill, X to bill. But of course it is called bills payable. X account debtor to bills payable account 10,000 rupees. 10,000 rupees. Sold goods to Y and Y became a debtor. So I collected a bill from him for the duration of 3 months. I know very well, I said very well clearly, I can handle the received bill in different ways, four ways. One, I can retain the bill. Second, I can discount the bill into bank. Third, I can endorse the bill to somebody. Fourth, I can send it to bank for collection. Say example, first case, bill is retained with me. If bill is retained with me till the due date, so need not to write any entry because it is already with me. So need not to write when bill retained with me, no entry required anywhere. Say example, sir, that bill is discounted into the bank, second case. So why the bill is discounted into the bank? Because I need the amount before the due date. So I cannot get that money from the drawee. So I may discount that bill into the bank. So bank will cut certain discounting charges and he will back give the money. Of course, that discounting charge is a gain to bank because on the due date he will get the complete full amount from the drawee. So when bill is discounted by X, how X is going to write the entry? Third, so when the bill is discounted into bank, how we are going to write? Say example, that is a 10,000 bill discounted by for 500 rupees discounting charge. That means what? You are getting cash or bank 9,500 debit. Discounting charge is a loss debit side. You are giving bills receivable back to banker. So bills receivable is you are giving out and going out credit side. Therefore, you may write the entry like this: cash or bank account debtor 9,500 you are getting. Discounting charges account debtor, discounting charge is a loss to you 500. You are giving your bill to banker, so bills receivable is simply going out credit side. When you discount your bill into the bank, and of course drawee will not write any entry. Okay, that is the way to handle the when bill discounted into the bank. So when you retain the bill with you, no entry, already it is with you. If you discount the bill, you have to write the, like this entry: no sir, and I endorsed my 10,000 bill to somebody. Say example, C is our creditor and to whom I have to pay. I endorsed my bill to C. Therefore, bill endorsed to C. Bill is endorsed to C. When I give my bills receivable to C, what I am going to write, how I am going to write the entry? Obviously, bill is going out credit side, C is a receiver debit side. C is account debtor to bills receivable account. Amount involved is 10,000. Of course, no entry again in the books of drawee. When I discount the bill, drawee will not write any entry because not concerned to him. I endorsed my bill to somebody, drawee will not write any entry for that. He is silent. And lastly, I can say that bill is sent to bank for collection. When bill sent for collection to bank. I said that banks are rendering so many services to customers nowadays. So, and I give bill to the banker to collect on behalf of me. And obviously, bills receivable going out credit, the bank is a receiver debit side. So I can write bank to bills receivable, but I want to make it very clear: bill sent for collection to bank account debtor, bill sent for collection to bank account debtor to bills receivable account 10,000 rupees. When bill is sent for collection to bank, bill sent for collection to bank account debtor to bills receivable account. Even in this case, no entry can be recorded in the books of I. When bill sent for collection to bank, bills receivable is going out credit side, the bank is a receiver debit side. bill sent for collection to bank account data to bills receivable account. So need not to write any entry in the books of I. And when goods are sold like this, when we received a bill for that, you can write like this. And I said we can handle in four ways. If you retain the bill, need not to write any entry, already it is with you. And now this is the way, when you discount the bill into the bank, you have to write, need not to write the drawing. When you endorse your bill to C, you can write like this, need not to write anything by B. If you send the bill to bank for collection, you may write like this, need not to write any entry by the Y. This is the way to handle. So whatever the way you handle, you can retain the bill, discount the bill, endorse the bill, or collection, send for collection. In all four cases, so the bill can be either honored or dishonored. Honor means payment is done. Dishonor is when payment is not done. Then how we are going to write the entries for the honor as well as dishonor of entries? We can discuss. Just record it neatly. Now let us try to know in all four situations when bill is honored, okay, and later we can see that how to write the entries for dishonor. And very very simple and easy to handle the entries. Let us see. So I'm going to say that when bill is honored, I can say four different cases. So when bill retained, when bill retained with him till the due date the bill kept with him and he approached the Y to collect the money and subsequently honored. Second, when bill discounted into bank, the bill is discounted into the bank, subsequently that is honored. Third, when bill is endorsed to Z, let us say the name of endorsee is Z, endorsed to Z. Fourth case, when the bill is sent for collection to bank. So these are all the four different situations. Let us see how to write the entries for all the different four situations. Very simply, as and when the bill is honored on any particular day, and drawee will write every time the same entry, simply the bills payable liability being discharged. So bills payable liability bring back to debit side, that is paid back to cash or bank. Either first situation, second situation, third situation, and even fourth situation. Under any situation, you may write the same entry when the bill is honored, particularly in the books of drawee. The liability is discharged. Simply bills payable to cash or bank account. But how you are going to write in the books of X, very, very important. In case of first case, bill is retained with him. When bill is honored and he can cancel the bill and or he can give back his bills receivable, of course he can get the money. So cash or bank is coming into the business and bills receivable is going out credit side to bills receivable account. If the bill is retained with you and your that bill is honored on the due date, cancel your bills receivable and of course collect the money. No second case, sir. When discounted bill is honored on the due date, no entry. Why? Because money will be paid by the drawee to the banker. Because already I took money from the bank. So bank on the due date will collect the money from Y. So I will not write any entry. And how to write the when bill is endorsed to Z subsequently honored? No entry. Because already I endorsed my bill to Z. Z will collect the money from Y. So I will not write anything. So he will pay the money to Z. Last case. Again, when bill is honored, when I send bill for sent for collection to bank, when I send bill for collection to bank, I made the bank as a debtor. So whenever collection is done, I have to cancel him. Therefore, entry cash or bank account debtor or bank account debtor to bill sent for collection to bank. Bill sent for collection to bank account. When I send bill to bank for collection, I made the bank is a debtor in my books. I will cancel him. And as and when money collected, I can debit the cash or bank. Cash or bank to bill sent for collection to bank. This is the way to handle the whenever the bill is honored to write the entries under four situations. Say example, now let us see when bill is dishonored. When bill is dishonored, then how to write the entries under four different situations again. Not the when bill is honored. Here bill is dishonored. Dishonored means payment is not done. Dishonored means payment is failed. Then how to write the entry? As in earlier liability bills payable liability discharged. But of course here liability is not discharged. Liability being cancelled. Whenever bills payable is honored, bills payable to cash or bank. When bills payable dishonored, bills payable cancel your bills payable. Again, you can make your X as a creditor in your books. Earlier bills payable to cash honored. If the money is not paid to X, to anyone, even the banker, he in case of discounting the bill, banker will approach the drawee. In case of Z, and also to Z, the Y actually dishonored the Z. But in fact, whoever approached the drawee to collect the money, and ultimately he can dishonor only X. I will tell you a small example here. X drawn a bill, Y accepted a bill. What actually done? X endorsed to A, A endorsed to B, B endorsed to C, C endorsed to D, and D discounted into bank. Into bank. Who will approach the Y to collect the money? Bank will approach to collect the money. If he is unable to pay the money to banker, dishonored means. So bank will get back the money from D. D will get money from C. C will get back money from B. B will get money from A. A will get money from X. X has to get the money from Y. So that ultimately he can dishonor only X bill. Because even he dishonored the bank, bank is able to collect the money from D. D has to collect from C. C has to collect from B. B has to collect from A. A has to collect from X. X has to collect from Y. So ultimately under any situation bill is dishonored, Y should make as a creditor only X. Therefore Y account debtor to X account under first situation, second, even third, and even fourth. Under any situation same. Honored means bills payable to cash or bank. Dishonored means bills payable to drawer's account or X account, whatever it is. Same entry under any situation. Let us see how to write this in this particular case. Under any situation, bills receivable, for example, bills receivable dishonored. Under any situation, I'll be like a creditor in the books of Y. and Y will be like a debtor in my books. Obviously, I have to get the money under any situation. Let us see that. I am writing under any situation Y account debtor. Need not to cross check it. I can write Y account debtor without any hesitation. Under first situation, when bill is with me and subsequently dishonored, I can cancel my bills receivable. I can make X as a debtor. Of course, amount same 10,000 under any situation. So need not to write that one also, 10,000. If discounted bill is dishonored and I can make Y as a debtor to me, I can make bank is credit in my books because I have to pay to the bank on behalf of Y. So I can make the bank is a creditor and Y is a debtor in my books because I have to collect money from money Y. I have to pay to the banker. So I can make the Y as a debtor, I can make the banker as a creditor. When bill is endorsed subsequently dishonored, I can make the Y is a debtor in my books and of course I have to pay money to Z. I can make the Z as a creditor to Z account. Y account debtor to Z account. So whenever I send my bill to bank for collection, I made the bank as a debtor in my books. If it is dishonored, I have to cancel the bank as a debtor in my books. I can make Y as a debtor. Y account debtor to bill sent for collection to bank. So be clear, in case of drawee books, when the bills payable honored, every time bills payable to cash or bank. When bills payable dishonored, under any situation bills payable to drawer's account, X account, and any situation. But here you should be very clear. In case of first case bill honored, cancel your bills receivable and get the money, cash or bank to bills receivable. Second situation, no entry because money will be paid by the drawee to banker. Third situation, no entry, money will be paid by the drawee to NRC. Fourth situation, cancel your bank as a debtor. Collect the money, cash or bank to bill sent for collection to bank. In case of dishonor, first case, cancel your bills receivable, make Y as a debtor. Discounted bill dishonored. You can make your Y as a debtor because you have to pay that money to the banker. You can make the bank as a creditor. Endorsed bill dishonored. You can make your Y as a debtor. And you have to pay the money to Z. You can make Z as a creditor. And lastly, you can cancel, already you made bank as a debtor in your books, you can cancel. Whenever dishonored, you can directly make your Y as a debtor in your books. This is the way to dishonor entries. Honor entries we came to know, dishonor entries we came to know. Particularly in case of dishonor, and we can see one very important point, that is a notary charge. Notary charge means whenever the dishonor has taken place and that should be registered in the court books, so that we should send a notary, generally holder of the bill, and when the, because drawee will, in the given situation, for example in this case bill dishonored, noting charges will be paid by whom, and why dishonored whom? The banker. Bank will pay the noting charge first, initially holder of the bill. To the banker, who will pay? D will pay. To the D, C will pay. C, B will pay. To B, A will pay. To the A, X will pay. To X, Y will pay. Noting charges always paid by the holder of the bill. Obviously, he can collect from the person from whom he received the bill. Therefore, under noting charges, under any situation, observe that noting charges, whoever may pay, ultimately he has to pay to the X. So X has to collect from Y. Okay. So that under any situation, if the noting charges taken place, so tell me one important point, noting charges will take place in case of honor or dishonor? Undoubtedly only dishonor. There is no chance of noting charges in case of honor. Under any four situations, noting charge incurred, let us say certain amount, no doubt it will be recovered from the drawee, that is a different matter. But anyhow, therefore, under any situation it can be recovered from Y, means that is obviously expense to Y. Therefore, he will write in his books noting charge like expense. So, noting charges accounted it or whatever the amount involved. Noting charges expense and should be debited in his books. And this amount should be paid back to whom? X. Under any situation, it should be paid to X only. So, he can make X as a creditor. Same entry under four situations. Observe that. Honored, bills payable to cash or bank. Dishonored, bills payable to X. Noting charge to X. Why? Noting charge is expense debit. Make X as a creditor. Under any situation, entry will be same. Let us come back to the books of X. In case of noting charge, first case when bill held with him, obviously he should go for notary. So that cash or bank is going from his hand. So cash or bank credit because money is going out. That money should be collected from Y account to debtor. Because when he kept bill with him, he has to pay the noting charge. So money is going out, he can make Y as a debtor. Second case, obviously noting charge will be paid by the banker. So that I have to collect the money from Y, of course I should pay the money to bank account. I can make for noting charges Y as a debtor because I have to collect. And I would like to pay back again to the banker. I want to make bank as a creditor in my books. In the case of endorsement, I will collect from Y and I will pay back that amount to Z because Z is the holder of the bill and he has to pay the notary charge. And I will collect from Y, I will pay to Z. I can make Y as a debtor, I can make Z as a creditor in my books. And last case, obviously when bill is sent for collection, when it's dishonored, bank will inform to me and I have to pay the notary charge. Same entry will be repeated here also. Y account debtor to cash or bank account. Whenever noting charges are paid, Y account debtor, in the initial case I will pay, even in the last case also I will pay, I will collect from Y. But in this case, bank will pay. I will collect from Y, I will pay to bank. In this case, Z will pay. I will collect from Y, I will pay to Z. This is the way to handle for the dishonor. So right now we have seen that how to write the entries under four different situations. When bill is honored, when bill is dishonored, particularly whenever bill dishonored, there is another important point. So we should discuss notable point, that is a noting charges. Under every dishonor, you may not find the noting charges. So you may find noting charges also in case of dishonor of a bill. So now we can discuss another important area, that is what rebate, settlement of bill of a bill with rebate, settlement of a bill with rebate. Settlement of a bill with rebate means once, for example, a bill is drawn for a period of 2 months or 3 months. Only 3 months after I have to pay the money, 10,000 bill. Say example, just after 10 days or 15 days, I am having sufficient money and I can approach the Y. So need not to wait for 3 months, sir. I can pay right now and all that amount. Then because you are paying earlier than due date and he will offer certain amount like a rebate. So how you are going to write the entry when bill is settled with rebate? How both people they used to write? I am giving my bills receivable back to him, going out credit side. Okay, so and bills receivable being collected from the Y. So and as and when bills receivable being collected before the due date, settlement with rebate. Say example, he is giving 9,500. I may write cash or bank account at 9,500. Remaining 500 will be lost to me. Rebate on bills discounted account at 500. So bill is going back credit side, cash or bank coming debit side, rebate on bills discount is a loss debit side. How the other party is going to write the entry? Bills payable discharged with lesser than the book value. Bills payable account debtor, let us say 10,000. to cash or bank, 9,500. To rebate on bills, 500. But of course, this rebate on bill loss to me, that rebate on bill gain to drawee, because earlier settlement. Here the bill is settled earlier than due date. That is what settlement of a bill with rebate. In settlement is done earlier than due date. So now we are going to discuss another one. Renewal of a bill. Renewal of a bill. What do you mean by renewal of a bill? Renewal of a bill means, say example, already I have written a bill on him for 10,000 rupees. But he is unable to pay the amount on the due date. He can request you to cancel the old bill. And he may request to write a new bill with particular amount of interest. Then obviously you may do like this. First you can cancellation of old bill. You can cancel your old bill. How the entry was written by you? Bills receivable to Y. Right now, Y to bills receivable account. 10,000. And he also can cancel whenever bill given by him to you, X to bills payable. Right now, bills payable to X. So you can cross check it whenever bills payable, bill is cancelled for mutual, cancellation is done. Entry is reverse entry passed. Y became a debtor in my books and you also became creditor in his books. Cancellation entry, dishonor entry, both are same. Okay, because this entry was written with an assumption that bill is with me. Under any situation, bill is dishonored. Cancel entry also you may write in the similar manner. And but of course in the narration you may explain the bill is cancelled. So what actually he said, okay, 10,000 bill being cancelled, right now I can pay 5,000 rupees cash to you. When a part payment is made, when a part payment is made, okay, let us say out of 10,000, 5,000 right now given, entry you may write cash or bank account debtor to, not bills receivable to Y, 5,000 rupees. How the other party will write? X account debtor to cash account, 5,000. Okay, we became the other party debtor in our books, but right now collection is done, 5,000. Then I asked him, what about remaining 5,000? He accepted with 200 rupees interest, he is ready to give a new bill. First, I would like to write for interest receivable. He is ready to give interest how much? 200. No doubt that interest is my income. So, credit side, I can make the other party Y as a debtor for that amount because I have to collect Y account debtor to interest. How the other party will write? Interest is expense to him, therefore debit. And he can make X as a creditor for that 2X account. 200. Interest is income, so credit, we can make the Y as a debtor. But there, interest is expenditure to him, debit, and he should pay to the X, he can make creditor. Fourth, lastly, for a new bill drawn and acceptance received for the same. So how you are going to write bills receivable account debtor to Y account 5,200, X account debtor to bills payable account 5,200. This is the way to handle the renewal, when bill is renewed, renewal has taken place. But this is one kind of renewal. Renewal may take place in any way. By the consent of both the parties, they can go for any kind of renewal. And I said this is one kind of renewals what generally we can see. Now we discussed when goods are sold by X to Y, how to write. Under four situations, retained with him, discounted into bank, endorsed, sent for election, how to write the entries. Honor under four situations, dishonor under four situations, noting charge under four situations, rebate on bills, discounted entry here and there, and renewal of the bill and how entries will be recorded both the parties. With this information you can handle any number of sums you can handle. Of course they will come from this particular area, names will be changed, amounts will be changed, but that's all. But every entry will be related to this. And lastly, only accommodation of bills left. We can discuss accommodation of bills in another class, and we can discuss some important problems related to these bills of exchange also in further 2 or 3 classes. All the best. Bye.